குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு ஆல். யா, நெக்ஸ்ட் 18 மினிட்ஸ் பேசிக்கலி ஐ அம் ட்ரை டு கவர் த டாபிக் ரீடிஸ்கவரிங் இந்தியா. தட் மீன்ஸ் இந்தியா வாஸ் தேர் ஆர் இஸ் தேர், சம்வேர் இட் ஹஸ் கான், வி ஹவ் டு ரீடிஸ்கவர். ஐ திங்க் தட்ஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம் யூ ஹவ் டு சீ நவ். Now connecting that rediscovery versus the Arana where I'm working, where the moon or space, connecting that basically accomplishments and opportunities in space, I think looks for 18 minutes may be a bit difficult, bit too easy also. See that once. We talk about rediscovering India. What came to my mind is something was there some time back, probably we lost somewhere in the timeline, we have to rediscover now. So in the cycle, basically I'm trying to put the cycle there. We were prosperous some time back. I think that is what history talks about. From Ashoka to Aurangzeb, we talk about India was supposed to be a prosperous country where the people were coming towards India. Then somewhere we lost the prosperity, possibly because of some people came and invaded, whatever happened, prosperity has been either taken off, or we have become more and more Indian people. We become underdeveloped, bottom of the line. 1947, yes, we are the same bottom of line, that so-called India came. Okay, prior to that, I think India as a nation was not, in some form not there, underdeveloped people, probably we have started developing, probably we have to go develop. Okay, rediscovery means, I think, I am connecting the cycle something like this. Now coming to the our shorter time frame, 1947 underdeveloped, 2000 onwards probably we are entering into the so called developing nation. Whatever the parameters you put, GDP, whatever you put, we have been declared as a developing nation. But today we are targeting, whatever with the reason, 2020 is the time frame where we have to be developed. Okay, and it is basically in the hands of you and me how we are going to do it and how space is going to be a part of such a journey. Now you look at here, human needs. Basically, when you're talking about developed country, we are talking about, yes, the nation has mountain, the nation has river, the nation has very many things. But we talk about the human beings, their basic needs to be taken care, basically food. Then comes other things like shelter needed, clothing needed. You have to transport yourself because you have to move one place to another. You have to communicate with others, you have to educate yourself, your own mass has to be educated. I think this is the basic need. If you are able to better off this than what you were some time back, then I think probably you can declare yourself developed. This is the parameter I am trying to put. A decent shelter, decent cloth, and decent education, communication, a decent transportation facility. If you are able to provide without any inequality, you are able to provide across the nation, then definitely you can tell I am developed. Now, these are all the things happening in the earth. But what space is going to do this earthy needs? That is the question, isn't it? We are talking about the space. How far the earthy needs, this space is going to help. Relevance of space program in India, that's what we are talking about there. That way to come, space is the vantage point. We'll be able to provide a leapfrog from developing to develop. That is what I am trying to talk about. That's what we are trying to do. That is somewhere down the line we lost. Okay, so when the industrial revolution was there, elsewhere happening, India somehow lost to grab the opportunity, both the industrial revolutions. But probably whatever we lost, we have to leapfrog. Without leapfrogging, same normal steps you cannot go. Space with the advantage point giving there, probably will be able to give us how we can move forward much faster rate. This is how I am trying to put here. Yes, the vantage point sitting there. For example, this as being demonstrated today, I am not talking about the air, I am not taking the space. What is being demonstrated today, probably we have to expand much, much, much broader way. Now you look at here, the communication. Today, we are talking about the voting percentage across the continent is much better than what it was earlier. Because people are aware of. Because people have been communicated with. People have been told with. Happened purely because many things are reaching to their drawing rooms. That is happening thanks to inserts. Basically, across the nation, irrespective of the language barrier, we are able to reach the people much better way. Insight is given. Meteorological, this is the Mediterranean region. We should know how the weather going on. We should understand that, and the communication should go properly. Again, when we talk about the education, healthcare, things like that, today this is the country which we have the fairly good educational backgrounds are there, but not good enough qualified teachers across the institutions in question mark. Similarly, we are talking about the qualified, well-versed doctors across the Indian continent being question mark. This gap can be bridged during this mode. Something called telehealth, tele-education, telemedicine probably will be able to help that. By demonstration, we have shown that it is possible to do that. So, yeah, this is how we are talking about tele-education. Say, you are seeing me here. Do you know? Basically, somewhere in the rural classroom, you are seeing under a tree classroom. This was my first 3 years of my schooling in Godavari village. Okay, today I am heading the things where the first EduSat program came under my leadership. That transition happened because of education. Education is the one which makes such a transition, but still we have the gaps. Probably these gaps can be filled up. You look at here, the teaching end is there. From teaching end to multi, whatever we talked about sometime back, we through radio we are reaching there. So this helps across the nation. We will go about multilingual also possible here to reach using the insiders hub. This is being demonstrated. Rural classrooms connected with the urban area classrooms are very much possible in a very, very interactive mode. This satellite helps that mode. Similarly, comes for telemedicine. You look at here, the Far East or Andaman, they are able to get multi-speciality hospital sitting in either Bangalore or Chennai. That specialist is able to give the healthcare expertise to the people sitting in the Far East or Kashmir or in the Andaman Nicobar. Without differentiating, it is Indians wherever they are able to get the expertise sitting, what is it there in Bangalore or Chennai or Delhi, they are able to get it. Thanks to INSAT. Similarly, we look at here, not only we are talking about the food, agriculture. This is the country we are talking about, agriculture. And agriculture point of view also, you look at here, how we have another group of satellites, not from the geostationary missions. We are talking about the polar sun synchronous orbits, which gives a fairly good number of today's available technology from 600, 700 kilometer away. It's possible to understand what the earth resources are and how our forest coverage is there. How our agriculture land is wasted there. Any pesticides will be given like that. And soil and land degradation mapping, watershed development, horticulture mission northeast, many things we are able to do it, connecting very many things using the space as a vantage point and the sensors available today. Connecting these things together, we are able to see even potential drinking water zones, we are able to identify using the existing zones. It doesn't mean we are only going to the moon, we are sending water on the moon. No, even across India, where the potential water zones are, the same satellites we are able to identify. This we are trying to connect. Again, you look at India is covered by all three sides of the sea. The ocean is very, very long, oceans are there. And this breadth and the length of the oceans are being monitored to give the feedback to the fisherman, potential fishing zones. Okay, food, we are talking about there, fish also is food. Potential fishing zones are being identified sitting in the vantage point of the spacecraft. It's able to give a forecast, not only the forecast of how the your cloud movement is there, trying to tell about the Thane storm is coming or not. We are talking about a huge fish catches also are able to identify, coastal zone mapping are able to do that. And similarly, disaster support also, satellite sitting there is able to provide. That means it's able to connect in a very, very big way all the our land resources, either in terms of forest, agriculture, water management, or we are talking about the lands, or the ocean, weather, climate. In case of a disaster also, we are able to, in case the existing communication networks will trust. Okay, Gujarat, when the very, very huge earthquake came, existing ground networks collapsed. Only satellite network we are able to manage, people to connect, so that disaster management can be carried out properly. And today, thanks to this sort of things available there, we are seeing off late, if you look at here, yes, we are getting the storm, we are getting cyclones, we are very many things happening here, but still, today we are able to save a fairly good number of lives we are able to save, thanks to things happening in the space. How it is happening here? You look at here, we evolved over the years. How minutely we can see, even sitting from 600, 700 kilometer, how minutely we can see the things in the ground. We are able to come to the submeter resolutions. We are able to see, that is the one which helps us to understand what's happening in the ground. This is another way of looking at the same, the sensors, looking from that, and the oceanography, ocean is concerned, we are able to see where the potential fishing zones are there. Okay, potential fishing zones are able to identify, and that goes to communicated to a handset is developed by ISRO and other combinations. It gives the fisherman a possible regions, where are the regions potential fishing zones are there, so that daily morning when you are going, he can go and catch the fish is concerned, it's coming there. Then we are talking about another campaign, wherein in the campaign mode is gone, Rajiv Gandhi National Drinking Water Mission. Across the nation, you can look at here, the fairly good number of states have been already covered. Here, what we are trying to put the statistics talked about, even Rajasthan, you take it here, out of 88% success rate, that is, when satellite gives a prediction, this place you can go for the bore well, for the drinking water is concerned, and when we take it, success rate, what is the success rate, out of nearly 2000 wells, nearly 88% of success, even Rajasthan. You look at place like Kerala, very well known, it is 100% success we are able to get. So, a fairly good number of Madhya Pradesh, 15,000 bore wells have been done. Okay, this translates into nearly 90% of success. It translates into government's investment coming in a much, much better way because of the satellite imagery sitting there, going for the common man. Space is not for somebody else. Space is for the common man also, Indian context. Now, connecting these things here, flood map, drought map, damage map, hazard zones, risk maps, like this, whatever is with the available data, available sensors, it's possible to decipher from the imageries what's happening there, and it will be connected and you will be able to get preparedness, something is going to happen further down the line, 6 months from now, this year, your crop, how it is going to be there in India, this feedback goes there, and that feedback accordingly planning people have to take care properly. Okay, today brinjal has to be imported means you need not wait for the crop not coming properly and react. You can take action much prior itself. So this is sort of inputs goes to the planning people, policy makers today, thanks to satellite sitting across Indian continent. Yeah. Now, these are all we are talking, it is not only going to the policy makers, okay? It goes to the common crowd, grassroots person. Now, it is something called village resource centers, okay? What all I told here is encapsulated into a something called village resource center. From the satellite, data comes there, and the space services, basically watershed management, the panchayat itself gets the data there, panchayat union later gets the data there, and the panchayat planning, how in case of a canal is there, how they can do it, happening there, and even across the continent, today we are seeing national highways are coming in a very big way. Satellites, cartography, in images going in a much, much bigger way for the survey of India's concern. Sitting here, we are able to do weather forecast is happening there, tele-education, these are all things encapsulated together, going directly to through a village resource center like Panchayat Union campuses are nowadays there, very many places. Those places will be equipped with this equipment. They will be able to get tele-education, telemedicine, even training. Okay, some sort of a training you have to give the people sitting there. How the motor pumps are there, how it's been repaired. Okay, the person sitting there will be able to get a training from a centralized place. From a centralized place, very many villages together, they will be able to get a training from your urban area. For urban area, draftsman, he gives the training, the people sitting in the rural area is able to go. This is happening there. This is the thing happening. Putting all the inputs coming from the satellite, reaching one place, village resource centers will are being equipped with to enable such things to happen. Yeah. When I am telling all these things, what are the assets? You look at here, the space assets as of today, India is having. India is having the space assets, into geosynchronous mission, as well as the polar sun synchronous mission, a fairly good number of missions in this continent, we are having it. Thanks to the space assets, that's what I was talking about happening here. So, these assets needs to be maintained, needs to be enlarged, need to be further we go about, so that the benefits, whatever we're talking about here, it goes in a much better way. Having done this, okay, I am a human being. I cannot tell my hand alone is muscle alone going this, I am strong. My leg alone is strong, I cannot tell. My chest alone going, I cannot tell. My head alone going, I cannot tell. I will be a complete man. Provider, I am in a complete in all respect. Similarly, it is not only we are here just for the food. Okay, everybody taking the lunch. We are taking lunch only in our, we are not only for that. Okay, we have something more is there. This is much beyond. Okay, now much beyond when we are talking about here. Looking at the earth, yes, how we can harness the resources, how we can effectively utilize the resources, that's what we talk about until now. Water, where it is there, we are telling. Fish, where it is there, we are telling. whether hurricane is coming or not, you are telling. Communication you are doing, entertainment you are doing, everything sitting in the space for the earth. Something more also can be done. Okay? Space is a very, very, very big place. Space has much more thing also. Is it possible to bring something from there for our own Mother Earth? That is another idea. Chandrayaan is one of the simplest steps what we have taken. Our modest step to get something beyond our universe, something beyond our place, go here and get back. Helium 3 is one of the things we talk about. Okay? Today we are talking about a nuclear fission based nuclear power we are talking about here. This year, in case you are able to bring back helium 3 in good number, helium 3 based nuclear reactors are radiation free. That gives possibly tomorrow's clear answer for the, our power is concerned. This is one of the things. Further also we can do. Space, from the space, we are talking about the solar power. It is very good, I agree. But solar power, how many days you can get? Okay? Even weather is very good, you can get. Again, even if weather is good also, not more than 8 hours per day, you can get the solar power. Isn't it? Sun goes so much away, and the sun vary, all the variations put together, even India, place like India, you cannot get the solar power more than 8 hours per day. Space gives an answer. Space gives you, look, you go to geostationary mission, it is only for 30 or 40 days per year, eclipse comes. Even during that time, solar eclipse is not more than 72 minutes. That means almost 24/7 at 365 days, you can get the solar power at that place. If you are able to convert that and able to bring back to here, you have near permanent solution from the space. Solar radiation you are trying to get here and get the power here, you can answer it much better way. That means going beyond, not only just using the vantage point, try to identify what the earth is there, much beyond also possible to. Chandrayaan is one of the modest example going there. When you are doing, yes, rediscovering India, India has to come back number one. This is another aspect of Chandrayaan. Okay, you look at here, ISRO being the center stage, you can look at the people who are all work under us. I am not aligned with this, work under us. Okay, this indicates we are rediscovering India in much better way. The cycle is coming back. Yeah, this picture I should do, post Chandrayaan. I have gone US after post Chandrayaan. First my visit to US, this is the picture, the Houston, the mecca of any aerospace engineer, where Armstrong when we landed, Houston, Eagle landed here, we told. That control center, when I entered, one of the four big screens, where other big screens are having the shuttle, the working, the monitoring going on. This is the one which welcome to Mailsami Annadurai, indicating what we have done it. My first visit to Houston, my first visit to US is concerned. And this basically, when I'm telling, it is not that basically it's talking about what I am. This basically is about what as in India has done it. What as an Indian space people have done it through Chandrayaan and how it has been acknowledged by Ina Houston. And this again, this is the team. The team, what it has done to enable that to happen. Again, you can look at here, the front line, and you can see the line is basically, you have the people US, you have the people from UK, you have the people from Germany, you have the people from Japan. There are very many people standing here. Indian people are standing in front. We are trying to rediscover an emerging world leader is happening in a space arena. Definitely it's happening there. Yeah. When we're talking about here, all the things are not happening in Bangalore. You look at here, again, this is across the length and breadth of India. We have the very many ISRO centers sitting there, all pulling together. This is what happening in India's concern. Now, having done that, I will take a few minutes. Now we're talking about new opportunities. These are all the story of what is being, what happened. Okay? What in Indian relevance space is being supplied. Now, probably something more can be done. Something better can be done. What it is happening. Now, you look at here. When basically satellites are classified, communication satellite, remote sensing, navigation, science. Okay? And now you have to improve the better and better. Satellites are giving bigger mass, power is increasing, complexity increasing. That translates into bigger launch vehicles. This is the phenomenon today. Whether something can be done for that. Bigger the satellite, larger the launch vehicle. Definitely happening. Larger the launch vehicle, issues are many. How it can be taken care? Ready? If you are ready to take the challenge, opportunities are plenty. That's what I'm trying to talk here. And if for that, you have to create the opportunities. For that, you be innovative. How we can be innovative? That is, you took one example of Steve Jobs. Okay? And this is basically innovation in the field of personal computing has done. But you look at the book, it talks about ideas are very, very crazy ideas. Okay, he has more than 200 patents. But many, many ideas are very, very crazy. But systematically implemented. Ideas may be crazy. but implementation is very, very systematic. You look at very many things like the cinema, TV, cell phone, car, air travel. To start with, ideas were crazy, but it has become much better way because they created the interest with very many people. Not only the crazy man was giving crazy idea, he was able to create interest with others, and that systematically is able to implement together. That's how all the things have been success today. What we got to today, okay? When I'm coming here, I have seen a lot of coconut trees. Okay, something came to my mind. Okay, I am putting it here. So the coconut tree is sitting here. Now you look at here, you pluck the coconut there. Somebody wants to mechanize the system. Okay, probably you can, something you can do here. You mechanize system, can go and plug it here. But if you have to grow like this, it's very difficult. Okay, even positioning around that, other two people are required. Even whatever mechanized system you do, even to position each around the tree, you need more people than the people are going there. An idea came. Innovation came. Our disease, the problem is taller the tree, to plug it, you need a mechanized system. Why can't do it slightly different way? You bring the tree itself down. Okay? Basically, the problem. Problem is not the right solution. You bring the problem itself down. Solution is available. So, we need not worry. You're looking at how to look the problem. Basically, I'm trying to tell how to look the problem. Solution can be the problem itself. This is another problem. Okay, the wet grinder. Okay, we are not telling about India's not having a real innovation. My own hometown had a very great innovation on this wet grinder. Okay, this Coimbatore wet grinders are known today, very many kitchens. How it has happened to start with? Okay, if you want to mechanize this, I think it is a very great robotics engineering work. Okay, if you want to simulate the same thing, okay, you give the stator there and you try to make a rotor here which gives enough pressure to the rise such that floor comes much better way to make it very, very difficult. Okay, but idea is slightly different idea came. What had happened there? Now he reversed it. Rotor has become stator, stator has become rotor. Okay, that's what happened here. So a moving system is kept there, and yes, with a static system has started moving, with a single monoblock motor we are able to realize this. Okay, the innovation is possible. As rightly Dr. Upadhyay has told, our nature gives. When observation, we are able to identify what is possible. So this is where it's possible. This is also an innovation. Today, kitchen, you look at here, your mother is not grinding using that. Basically, wet grinders are available today. Thanks to that, happened there. So invert the problem, also solution can come. So this is the way innovations are possible. So innovation, possibly problem can be complex, but you can have some crazy ideas. That probably comes with simpler solutions. So that means simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Okay, that is the basic thing. You should be as simple as possible. The problem may be complex, solution is simple. Okay, so it is needed. It took nearly 70 missions to go to the moon, not able to tell water in the moon are there or not. Okay, because everywhere they landed, brought back the sand and told what is not there, what is not there. Slightly changed. We went around the moon, looked each part of the moon, and we are able to tell these are all the places water is there. There's a difference. Okay, the answer was already existing. Only thing is we have looked at the things slightly different way. Answer we could get back. So now we come back to ours, having put that all the things. Now we come back to our problem. Our problem is bigger satellites, larger launch vehicle. Larger launch vehicle issues are many. How we can reduce this? Issues are many that you have to cut it. How I can cut it? Larger launch vehicle, I don't want to do. You see? But without larger launch vehicle, what I can do? That means I should not have a larger launch vehicle. Bigger satellite should not be there. Okay, meaning is that. Okay, without bigger satellite, how we can do? Now we come back again, what we are doing. Again, we are not starting in the air. You look at the classification of satellites. Well, we have a lot of satellites, more than 3000 kg satellites we are making. Smaller satellite, including our SUTSAT, is less than 1 kg we are able to realize. Okay, now is it possible to put something better to realize what your overall objective? That's what we should think back here. So that means we should aim, possibly, as morning we have seen there, bigger cell phone, here has shrunk some smaller, isn't it? Now, basically today you look at here, the facilities offered by today our the duo SIM card, the cell phone is much greater than what we are cell phones we had those days. Okay, but similarly, is it possible to have nano satellites to have this? And while doing like this, it will have new applications. We are able to do. Let us do that. Advanced process components. Today, electronics is very, very advanced components and technologies available. Is it possible to extend this to the space? space gives another challenging things for electronics, but is it possible to take it there? And probably we are able to reduce the cost. And it gives new talents. Basically, without new talents, it's not possible. Older people will be thinking in older way only, isn't it? Older people, to make it think new, new talents have to come. To make it new ways possible. So, attract the new talents, then only new ideas will be able to push through this. So, problem for new satellites, today we have a lot of challenges, because basically when you work in some electronics work in space, you have to work against the space radiation, you have to work against the vacuum sitting there, you have to work against the temperature regime sitting there. But still, if you work, these are all the problems today, these are all the problems today, but these problems have to be overcome over the years. Your new ideas today is very much required, because you have seen what are all the benefits India can reap. Okay, India has to leapfrog. Unless you do leapfrog, you nothing called a discovery is possible. Rediscovery of India, you want to do. Unless there is leapfrog, this 1.2 billion people cannot attain all the benefits. That to happen, something drastic, even beyond the earth, from you have to bring in. To bring in that space is the alternative. To bring that to happen, we have to make it a very, very simpler solution. Problem may be sufficient. That's what I told. Simpler solution you would arrive at. Possibly you can do that to happen. Basically, this is what I'm putting. Approach the problem more systematically. Just take one of few examples of that. And emerging micro and nanotechnologies. Is it possible to marry these things together? What is happening here? Is it possible to marry these things together? Make a simpler, very, very cost-effective, very less small satellites is possible to make. Small, inexpensive satellites that can play a role. Spacecraft on chip and missions are on the horizon. Okay. Now, on the chips, like your cell phones available, on the chips, micro satellites also on the horizon. You must able to academia. This is the point. This is the place. I used to tell every time. There is a time for everything. Everything in its time. There is a place for everything. Everything in its place. There is a man for everything. Everything has its man. I believe. Today, this is the place, this is the time, you are the people, definitely you can make, grab this opportunity. And definitely opportunity, Chandrayaan is a very, very modest example. If you do well, as many places I told, in your motherland, in front of your father, in front of your mother, how this nation, whether Chandrayaan would not have outlived those many days, but still, definitely these people will take you, yes, definitely they will take you as a hero, that this motherland is waiting for you. Today, it's very much possible, opportunity is very good, small satellites offers opportunities and challenges for academia. Academia takes this opportunity and takes it. It helps for the both nation as well as for you. You also can be a part of the nation builder. It's very much possible. Thank you. Thank you very much.